We sure appreciate being here. By round of applause, how many of you guys have seen an improv show before? Or I guess you could just formally tell me.
1, 2, 3.
Awesome, awesome, awesome. So improv means that we're making this all up on the spot. We have no idea what's going to happen. This could be the most incredible thing you've ever seen. We'll call it the greatest show ever. Or it could be terrible. And we'll call it art. And we'll go on there and we'll go on from there. So what I need from you, it's heavily rely on you guys, especially you four. So if you thought you were going to sit back and relax, forget about that. You're going to be chorus by the end of the night. So anything can happen. So I'll ask for a suggestion. What's the last book you read?
Harry Potter?
Most in the world?
Heights,
spiders.
Spiders like the ones in Harry Potter.
Falling into spiders. Falling into spiders. That would be a terrifying fear. And who in here has the coolest job? It's not a lot of competition, but who thinks they have the coolest job in the room?
Baby does.
Yeah, he does.
You totally do? What's your job?
I work here.
You work here? Awesome. That is pretty rad. And no one can be working at the Covey Center? You all lose. Okay, perfect. Let's give it up. So anything can happen. We don't know what's going to happen in this first act. We could see we could see a character about someone who works at a theater.
This credit card expired in 1972.
Yes. Okay, very good. Very good. We could see a scene about being afraid of heights and spiders.
Spider's a little bit tall, right?
One of us ran up and stole the food and ran off. And then the person driving the car
looked and was like, oh man, and jumped out and ran after that person.
Oh,
and then the other person ran up and jumped in the car and drove away.
Okay, I want to see a scene where it's on the other side of the window, what's going on in the kitchen of the restaurant while all of this is going down outside.
One more screw up, Miguel, and you're fired.
Okay,
I'm going to supervise this transaction, and if it doesn't go well, you're getting deported back to Finland.
It'll be fine.
Why'd they get so many European immigrants working in here?
I don't know. McDonald's isn't what I used to be, boss.
I know. My great-great-great-great-great-great-grandfather used
to be. Guys, they're doing it again.
What?
Some people are stealing Wendy's right out of my hands.
I didn't do it. They stole it. I didn't put it
But she's your daughter, Franklin. This is on your head.
Wait. No. Don't send him back to Finland. He'll never make it back out of the ice.
Not with this poor accent, I won't.
Exactly. Get me the blue water paint, I'll go after him.
We can have the fry sauce before we color it.
Ah, perfect, thank you. Yeah. Alrighty.
Alright,
that'll be 14. Now, we're gonna go get those kids who stole that food. They stole $4.37 worth of merchandise. It's
oh,
totally
they did
worth
it.
Nice.
They keep stealing.
Gosh darn these kids!
That means they're gonna be coming back.
Let's wait for them.
They always come back.
With the spatula. Later that night.
Is that them?
They look hungry.
They look like little hoodlums.
Hungry to die.
They literally have hoods on their heads.
I have a question. Am I the only one who actually works while I'm here?
Yes!
Keep working.
This is very important.
Here's the spatula.
I've sharpened it into a shape.
Perfect.
If you move slow enough, they won't see you.
They got away. Gosh darn it, guys!
Going back to the We like to be an improv troupe that gives back, and everyone could use a word of advice from time to time, right? I'm sure that everyone has some questions they might want advice on. And so we're going to sing you some advice tonight. And we're going to do that one word at a time, all four of us.
Sweet. This is my favorite way to give advice.
Okay.
Mine too.
So anyone, any kind of advice question you have, just go ahead and raise your hand and let it out. New parents know it all. Come on.
Soon to be parents, I'm sure you got it. You got this down.
And you know that we can all answer your questions.
How about ice breastfeeding?
Yes, that's exactly what we want to talk about tonight.
Perfect.
Yes.
This panel is three men and one woman, so now answer.
This one, unmarried woman, yes.
Reminds me of the Rockabye Baby on the Tree. top. Like, what child can't be afraid of heights after
Stay in your out? Bed, or else.
So, that's the lullaby that we've heard. That kind of backwards. Just things not seeming, things aren't what they seem. You know, it might be fun if we,
I want to see what brought Mr. Murbeck or Burbeck or whatever to that point in his life.
Yeah, can we have a musical narration while two people perform that? Two people are singing what's happening, what made Mr. Is it Burbeck?
Burbeck,
what it is, okay. So what we show you tonight was kind of a smattering of what we could do. Scene work, song work, games, humor. But what we do is the thing that makes us different from everyone else here in Utah and really in most of the world with our improv troupe is we get to make up musicals, which is our most fun thing to do in the entire world. But our musicals are completely inspired by you. So what we're going to do is we're going to take a little time to get to know you a little bit. We want your stories, your experiences, and we're going to have a 10-minute intermission for you guys to get breaks and whatever else you do. And within that 10 minutes, we are going to write a musical for you, a full-length musical based off of you. So I'll start off with the first question, is what is the what's the thing that you're most proud of in your life? Most proud of?
My husband getting into grad school.
Grad school. What grad school? Yeah. Excellent. What grad program did you get into?
Physical therapy at Rocky Mountain University.
Awesome. My friend just graduated from there. She loved it. She's working at IHC now and being paid pretty well. That's pretty awesome. What motivated you to go that route with your career?
I decided I wanted to do something in medicine, but I didn't have the stomach to put people under the knife. So I thought this was an alternative route. That was
so you want to grind their muscles, but you don't want to cut their organs.
That'll do.
That's perfect. Good choice.
Tenderizing meat. All right. What's a dream somebody's had recently that was a little weird, or just very normal dream?
About fast food.
About
inconvenient fast food dreams.
Yes.
I had a really weird dream, but I have really strange dreams.
Oh, bet.
That's
even
better.
Hey,
yes.
Okay, if you want to hear it.
Yes, but let us know.
Okay, so I was on a beach, and I'm pretty sure it was California. It was like a murky. But I was in a carriage, like an old time carriage. There were no horses, but it was moving by itself.
Oh.
I was in the back seat. This was like kind of like Halloween-y, so it was really creepy. And James Marsden was in the back seat with me. And he had an eel pet.
Of course.
And I had an eel pet. And they merged together. They kind of like sniffed each other out and they merged into one two-headed eel. And then we made out.
So the wee wasn't referring to the two
no,
separate heads.
No, no, it just did that. It was very weird.
And that was the whole dream that you woke
that
up?
That was the whole dream I woke up.
Oh my gosh.
Weird, right?
That's the best makeup dream ever.
Yeah. It's one of the
fun. It's what's your crazy dream?
Oh, yeah.
So we had a bunny 6 or 7 months ago.
Yeah.
And we left it with a friend and it ended up dying with our friend.
Was your friend named Mr. Rubik?
Just
lots of rum. Yeah. Well, no.
Wow.
Behind
okay,
the
I was joking.
Sounds like India all of a sudden.
You would
Because you could still gather and remember your loved ones and look at the junk heap.
With your livestock.
Grandpa,
you always loved this cow.
It used to have a lot more because it used to be a lot smaller town. We used to have only one stoplight, but now it's lots of.
We got three stoplights.
Now it's totally sold.
And a gas station.
And a Walmart.
A Walmart. Well, Walmart's up everywhere. So,
you say we burned it down.
There's no musical called Once Upon a Time?
Once Upon a Swine?
I think there's a TV show.
It's a TV show.
I watched it for a while.
Once Upon a Swine?
Once Upon a Swine.
Once Upon a Swine.
All right,
what we need you to do, we're about to go out for a 10-minute break. What we need you to do is I need you to go on your phones and go on Improv Broadway's Facebook page. If you've liked us already, what I need you to do is I need you to leave us either like a funny line of dialogue you want us to do or a song title that doesn't exist, and we're going to try to incorporate that into the musical. We will see you guys all in 10 minutes. We put the music on. Thank you guys. See you soon.
Big Farmer.
got a room for so long. My parents, they hear me. I think they can hear my song.
The kind.
father, mother time. It's where we talk about our lives, and this is where we share all our.
Massage.
That's right. Oh, take it off. Oh, the bunion. Don't forget the bunion. Both of them.
Sweetie. The unspeakable has happened.
What? Don't speak of it then.
We must speak of it. Sweetie. Look. I got on the interweb like you told me about.
You know what our people say about the internet?
Yeah.
It is
the spawn of Satan.
Stan. Oh, it was Stan. Stuff. Oh, it is Stan.
We call him Stan for short.
Yeah.
Look, our son was looking up apartments in Maples.
Get out of town, you put.
No, that's what he wants to do. He
no!
Wants to get out of town.
He thinks he's too good for pacing. Get my shoe. I did that out of anger. Oh, I'm so sorry.
Look, you know that if he leaves this pig farm to just you and me, which basically means me, because you don't do a whole lot.
Oh, come on. You know the eye candy keeps the motor running. You look at me like, oh, I'm going to give up, but then I give you a boom, 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 and you keep on
chugging.
Chugging,
yeah. Anyway. If he leaves us, we're ruined.
Who's going to tend the pig cemetery? Who's gonna watch? Make sure that our rabbits don't die. We don't want to leave them with friends. They'll be dead for sure.
Yeah. But I've heard the rabbits come from that.
What?
Maybe that's what we need to do with him. Maybe if we let him go just like that dead rabbit, he'll come back.
Okay. That seems like a plausible answer.
So are you ready to let our dead rabbit son go?
Speaking of mysteries and riddles, husband and unwoman. Yes. We'll let him go. We'll let him go off and do his thing. We'll let him wander the land. But I'm sure that the good Jewish Lord that we believe in will inspire him to come back with confusing dreams and visions. Visions that will confuse him and make him angry and a little bit sad.
Mapleton does that for a lot of people.
Mapleton's an evil. We'll let our son go. basketball. It's very fragile.
We don't play sports. We're very docile people.
No. What's wrong with you? You look confused.
I got engaged.
To my son.
Yeah. Getting married.
You look so excited.
I am. I'm excited. I'm just a little nervous, I guess.
Sarah, I don't think you should marry my son.
Why not?
Sarah.
I know.
Sarah.
Isn't that obvious?
Yes, let's be honest for a minute, Mel. Look at you. You can carry more pig weight than he can.
You're right.
And plus,
you're
I've seen right. The way you look at me. That's nothing to be ashamed of.
I always loved an older woman.
I'm taken. But Sarah, listen. You gotta be honest with yourself. You can't just marry him just because he's the only person you're not related to in our small town. That's no reason to marry anybody.
You're right.
Before you know it, you'll be knocked up and seeing a show with four people
now. You're right. I need to be honest with myself.
Let's be honest. Say that joke again.
Let's be honest.
Let's be again. I made that up myself.
It's funny every time.
Oh my gosh. It's mixing lesbian with honest in one word. Be honest about lesbians.
It made coming out of the closet so easy.
Oh, it was like a joke, you know? But it's real. It's a real problem. I don't want you to marry someone you're not in love with. So sorry. Calm down. I know I have that effect on people. But seriously, you need to marry for love and find your own way and find your own path and make sense for you. Can you imagine a world in which you could just be happy and not have to worry about the pretense of worrying about what people think of you or who you're supposed to? Gosh, this freaking boa! No more!
I'm glad I didn't get hit by the closet door.
You doing all right back there? In your carriage?
Huh? I'm in a carriage?
Yes, we're riding on a carriage, Gary.
Where's my accent?
Look who's with you, two unsuspecting friends. Two fresh eels, and one of them who looks like that hot guy who played Cyclops.
Well, hey guys, how have you been?
I'm an eel.
I see that.
Thought you should know.
Yeah?
We've been eels this whole time.
Maybe you're an eel too.
You're merging. You're merging, Gary.
I think I'm merging with them. Oh my gosh, they have two heads.
Why is this happening? What?
Who is?
How much you like it?
Whoa. Oh my gosh.
Whoa.
I think we need to break up.
But not until we make out.
There's also rabbits in this train. Rabbits multiplying.
Somewhere really, really, like, fantastic, you know?
More bustling, more fantastic than Payson?
Yeah!
You really are an idiot.
Dad!
But you're my idiot.
Thank you.
Look, all I ever wanted was to run this pig farm with you and your mom, and that masculine girl that you hang out with.
She's great, isn't she?
I don't see a better life than what we have right here.
Dad, I've asked her to marry me. And
you did?
Yeah. So that we can start our life together and get out of this place and continue on. I know that everyone else in town knows that I'm your kind of messed up boy, you know, how he was born with six toes on one leg,
well,
on one foot.
Your mother and I, we checked everything out online and it's a distant...
That ancestry.com just didn't work the way...
I didn't know she was my cousin till after. It's worked out fine.
Not for me, it hasn't.
What's one toe to you for our happiness?
But when you do the little piggies, the wee little piggies that go to market, now I've got the sixth little piggy.
Yeah, Jebediah. That's what we called him, remember?
I've always hated Jebediah. You've loved him more than you've loved me.
Well, maybe Jebediah doesn't talk back like you do.
Well, maybe that's because Jebediah is a toe, but we'll move past that. I don't
but
know.
Son, just put it out there. Tell me honestly why you want to leave this
were amazing, fantastic. You may have been. Where I can be free to eat bacon where everyone's not Jewish Canadian immigrants like ourselves. And I can just, you know, fit in. No one will know about Jebediah. No one will know about my super butch girlfriend. No one will know that I'm not really Irish. It'll be great.
Something I deserve. I guess something I need to say to you then. Maybe people will actually accept me for who I am. Maybe I'll be able to work out a little bit more. That 6 to 12 really got in the way of working out machines. Maybe I'll be able to lift as much as Sarah. And then maybe she'll like me better. Maybe she'll really want to marry me. I just,
first place. I know. I would have such better prospects. I mean, my dad did tell me to go find my bacon. And I know if I start cooking bacon in the house, Mom would freak out. Maybe.
Nothing more, but she will only marry someone who carries on the
Is that what it'll take?
Yes. Yes. Repress and go forward. That's our motto. Repress and go forward.
I always wondered why we had that written on the wall.
Yes. A family crest right next to a pig that's flying a winged rabbit. My ancestors were very weird. Well, now we've gotten this taken care of. Let's go back to Payson and tell your father.
Okay.
Let's tell your father. Don't forget the fruit basket. Spent all day making it.
Sarah, thank you. I know you. I love fruit. Let's go.
So does she. Children, and the whole process that goes along with it. Isn't this wonderful?
It's amazing. You're sure about this, son?
I realize that.
And other son?
Oh, he killed the other one, sorry. But we'll move on from that.
Oh, I was talking about Jebediah. I saw him in the pantry.
He's pickled now. He's in pickled heaven. As we read in the Torah, the book of Shankshanks, Book 44, verse 31, subsection B.
That's one of my favorites.
And thus Picoleth, the absorbed twin, goes on to become part of the Thor, and then later becomes back as a husband or a father, or maybe a second cousin, and will annoy you until you remember his birthday. Amen.
Loose interpretation.
Yes, I don't speak Hebrew, but I do Wikipedia.
I read the Cliff Notes myself.
Well, what are we waiting for? We've got a wedding to plan and do right now.
Take
it. This was fun with 7 people. Imagine what we can do with 10 people. Thank you so much for cast tonight with Matt Chase.
And Andrew.
Yeah, and Zach Atherton.
And of course, the one.